Hello everyone. So let us see a numerical on thermal diffusivity. So he has given calculate the thermal diffusivity of iron and water. Do the comparison. Okay. And properties are given. So he has given the properties of iron and water and asking to calculate the thermal diffusivity. Okay. So guys, let us see. So what is thermal diffusivity? We know or not? Thermal diffusivity is given by alpha is equal to k kappa by rho Cp. Alpha is equal to k by rho Cp. That is heat conducted in the material to the heat, ability to store heat inside the material. So this will become how much? This will become k is equal to let us calculate for iron. Let us calculate for iron first. So alpha iron will become conductivity of iron, which is 80.6 divided by rho Cp. Rho is your 7870. Into my Cp of iron is 0.45. This is in kg per meter cube. This is in kilojoule per kg Kelvin. And this is your conductivity, which is watt per meter Kelvin. So Kelvin will go, kg will go, meter and meter cube will go. So this will be meter square. And kilojoule and watt. This is watt and this is kilojoule. So it must be in watt. So this will be kilojoule per. Sorry, this will be joule per second. Joule per second. So we have to write it in watt. 10 to the power 3. This must be in joule per kg Kelvin. Okay, guys. So joule will go. Then the remaining unit will be your meter square per second. Okay, guys. So let us calculate this. How much it will be? So this will be 80.67870 multiplied by 0.45 into 1000. And 80.6 divided by this will be 2.27 into 10 to the power minus 4. 2.27 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square per second. Okay, guys. So let us calculate for iron. So what are the properties for iron? He have given you conductivity of iron and specific heat of iron. So alpha iron will become the conductivity of that is 0.608 watt per meter Kelvin, and this will be 1000, density will be 1000 multiplied by Cp will be 4.8118 into 10 to the power 3. Similarly, this will become in joule per kg Kelvin. And this is in kg per meter cube. Again, kg will go. And this will be watt per meter Kelvin. So again, meter will go. The meter square will be remaining. And kk will go. The remaining part will be joule will go. So this will be in joule per second, so joule will go. So again this will become meter square per second, and this will be your 4.18 into 10 to the power 3, okay, 0.608 divided by this. So this will become 1.45 into 10 to the power minus 7. So this is becoming 10 to the power minus 7, and this is coming to be 10 to the power minus 4, maybe you can see the difference. That difference is of 1000. So thermal, we can say what, thermal diffusivity of iron is very high, okay, compared to the thermal diffusivity of the water. So the iron will conduct heat fast in comparison to the, so this is water, this is your water, I think this is your water, not iron, this is your water. So water will conduct heat in what, in a, iron will conduct heat in a very fast manner in comparison to the water, because water is having low thermal diffusivity. So water will try to absorb all the heat rather than conducting it throughout it. So this was this. So conclusion is that this is useful for better heat transfer. Okay.